Hey dolls, welcome back to my channel. I am Jodi Janelle. In this video, I'm going to be showing you guys a closer look at my roller set routine on my wash days. I'm really trying to tread along on this healthy hair journey, so I'm starting off on freshly washed, deep conditioned hair. And if you guys want to see my full wash day routine, I'm going to link that video down below from my last wash day. So I've always roller set my hair, even as a teenager. It's just a healthier method of drying your hair without adding additional heat and getting a silky, smooth finish to your hair. So the first thing I'm going to do is add some Azayam castor oil water to my hair. I normally use my Lotta Body setting lotion with some water in it, but I've just been really enjoying this Jamaican castor oil water. It smells amazing and it has some really amazing ingredients and properties to help your hair grow. It helps with breakage and just rejuvenating your hair. So with my sectioning, I always start out in the front first. I'm going to be doing three sections at the front and using two different size rollers. I'm going to be using size large and medium. I probably need to get extra large rollers now since my hair is getting a little longer. And of course, I'm going to be using the roller pins to secure the rollers to my hair. So when I'm doing my rollers, I don't focus too much on my parting, but I want to make sure that my hair is laying flat and smoothly against the roller and that it's tight in my hair all the way down to my scalp, that it's not loose and flopping in my hair. So it holds my hair tightly and that helps my hair get a silky smooth dry. So I won't be doing too much talking in this video, but I really wanted to give you guys a closer visual demonstration of how I section my hair and how I do my roller placement. this is what everything is looking like after I'm done with my roller set. So I'm just going to give a quick light spray of some oil sheen to my hair before I go under my hooded dryer. And it normally takes my hair about an hour, hour and a half to fully dry if I take no breaks, because that dryer is no joke. It gets really hot under there. So if I don't take any breaks, it's about an hour and a half. If I do, it could take up to 2 hours for my hair to fully dry all the way to the end. So this is what my hair is looking like when it's all dry. I'm just going to add a little more moisture and shine to my hair with my shine polishing hair oil. Just a light coat all throughout my hair. And obviously, if you want to keep your curls, you can just finger rake your hair and use a rat tail comb just to smooth down your edges. But for me, normally when I take my rollers out, I thoroughly comb through my hair and do a flat wrap to preserve the volume in my hair for the next day. So if you guys want to see how I do my flat wrap, or if you want to see a full detailed video of how I do my wash day routine, I'm going to link those videos down below. Don't forget to check those videos out. And let me know how you guys enjoyed this video. Give it a thumbs up. Leave your comments down below. Let me know what tips and tricks you guys use when you're roller setting your hair, if you do that method at all. If you're a person who enjoys the silk press, let me know how you guys are enjoying it, how you do your silk press and achieve your wash day results. Thanks so much for watching, guys. I truly appreciate your support. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and give this video a thumbs up. And I'll see you in my next video. Bye.